Hi, in this video I will explain you step by step on how to install Stable Diffusion on your PC. We will use automatic 11.11 web interface, which is kind of the most popular UI right now. We will also install some of the most used extensions and generate our first AI image. Please note that you need an NVIDIA graphics card with a minimum of 4 GB of VRAM in order to run this. As usual, all the links featured in this tutorial will be in description. So sit tight and let's begin. First, we have to go to the GitHub page for automatic 11.11. Just Google it and click on the link where it says Stable Diffusion Web UI. You will see something like this. Scroll down to the installation and running section and find automatic installation for Windows. First, we need to download Python 3.10.6. Just click on it and it will take you here. Scroll down and find the Windows installer 64-bit and download it. Now go back to GitHub page and click on Git. From here, download the one that says 64-bit Git for Windows. Once your downloads are complete, go to your downloads folder and install Python by double clicking on it. Make sure to check the option Add Python to Path and then click on Install Now. Once it's installed, go back to Downloads again and double click on Git. Uncheck the Only Show New Options and press Install. Leave everything to default and keep pressing Next until you reach here. Hit the Install button and wait for the process to finish. Once it finishes, it may open some web pages, so just close them. Now go back to the install instructions and copy this line here. Go to Explorer window and create a new folder where you want to install Stable Diffusion. Make sure to choose a drive which has a good amount of empty space, because the size can easily cross 5 to 6 GB during installation. You may also need to download custom checkpoints and plugins, so make sure you have 30 to 40 GB of free space before installing. I will create a new folder and name it Automatic 11.11. Now open the folder and go to the address bar. Write cmd and hit enter. This will open a command prompt. Paste the line you copied and hit enter. Now it will download some files on your PC. It may take a while depending on your internet speed. Once it's finished, you will see a new directory here. Just open it and go inside. Here you can see a lot of files and folders that were just downloaded from the GitHub repository. Scroll down and find the WebUI user batch file. Right click and open it with Notepad. Here we can add some command line arguments which can help in improving the performance of Stable Diffusion. First write --xformers and then give a space and add --med VRAM. Although this is not necessary, but if you have a low VRAM of 4 to 6 GB, this will greatly improve the performance. Since I have a pretty low VRAM of just 4 GB, so I will use some more command line arguments like --opt-channels-last and --opt-split-attention. After testing a lot of command line arguments, I found this one to be the best for my NVIDIA RTX 3050 Ti. Means it got me the best speed of generations. Also add --auto-launch and it will automatically launch the web UI in your default browser whenever you run the batch file. Once you are done, just save the file and close Notepad. Now before launching the app, we have to download Stable Diffusion model. Since we have not downloaded any model yet, so let's just download the base model for Stable Diffusion, which is Stable Diffusion 1.5. You could also go for version 2.0 or 2.1, but version 1.5 is much more popular than 2.0, so let's just download that. There are two popular places where you can download your models. The first is Hugging Face and second being Civit AI. First, you can download the default checkpoint, that is Stable Diffusion 1.5, from Hugging Face website. You can find its link in the description below. Go to Files and Versions and scroll down. Here you can find multiple versions of the checkpoint. There's CKPT file and Safe Tensors file. Safe Tensors are usually considered safer than the CKPT files because the CKPT can be modified to contain malicious code, but Safe Tensors can't. Although that rarely happens, but just go with the Safe Tensor to be on the safer side. You can also see pruned and EMA only model here. Pruned models are useful if you want to do fine tuning or training, but if you just want to generate images, EMA only models will be sufficient. So we will download the EMA only Safe Tensor model because we just want to generate images. Usually the default model don't always produce great results, so for that we use the fine tuned models. Since this was just a base model, let's download a fine-tuned model from the community now. For that, we will go to cbitai.com. There are tons of great community-trained models here. You can explore and find the ones you like and download them. For example, I will download the model called Dream Shaper. The size of this model is around 5GB, which is fairly a normal size for most trained models. That's why you should install a Stable Diffusion on a drive that has decent amount of free space. Okay, so I have downloaded the file now. I will move the model to the Models folder. Go to your Stable Diffusion WebUI folder and open the Models folder. Here we have to look for Stable Diffusion folder. Now, paste the model here. Any fine-tuned model that you have downloaded must be copied here if you want to use it with Automatic 1111. As you can see, I already have a few models here which I have downloaded earlier. Now, go back to Stable Diffusion main directory and start the WebUI by double-clicking on the WebUI user batch file. If it's the first time you are launching Automatic 1111, then it will download some necessary files after launching. It usually takes around an hour depending on your internet speed, so just wait till everything gets finished. Since we already added auto-launch in the batch file, so it will automatically launch a browser window when the process gets finished. If you have not added the auto-launch in your batch file, then you need to copy this local URL and paste it in your browser. You have to do this manually every time you run the application, so that's why auto-launch is really helpful in this case. Now we can start creating our very first AI art by typing our prompt in the text box here. I have already got a prompt ready with me, so I will just copy and paste it. And now I hit generate. As you can see, her face got cropped from the left side. This is because we have used the default dimension of 512x512. Let's change it to 512x768 since we are trying to generate a portrait image. Now I will hit generate. This is the result. Since we are using the default Stable Diffusion 1.5 model, so let's change it to a different one from the selection menu at the top. I will select Dream Shaper version 5. We can also change the sampling method here. Now what are these? Stable Diffusion generate images by trying to denoise an extremely noisy picture. So this whole denoising process is called sampling, and hence this is the list of samplers. Let's change it to DPM++SD-Keras and also increase the number of sampling steps to 30. I will keep the same prompt and generate. As you can see, it got much better than before because we used a fine-tuned model. To learn more about image generation and prompting, you can check out other videos on my channel. Now, let's install some of the extensions and plugins. Go to the Extensions tab and click on Available. Now click on this orange button that says Load From. It will load all the extensions that are available for Automatic 1111. Go to the search bar and type Aspect Ratio. Install the one that says Aspect Ratio Helper. This will add an aspect ratio selector so that you can set a dimension of your image before generating. Once it's installed, you can see that it's available by going to the Installed tab. Let's go back again and search for another extension for prompt auto-completion called Boru tag. It will come handy when you type the prompts. Just like this, you can also install other extensions like Ultimate SD Upscale and ControlNet. Once all the extensions are installed, go to Install tab and hit the Apply and Restart UI. That's it. You can install more extensions the same way if you want them in the future. Congratulations, you have successfully installed Stable Diffusion on your PC. You can pat yourself in the back now and start generating unlimited number of AI images for absolutely free. Please subscribe if you found it helpful, and I will see you in the next one.